ha ha. Finished the show, and then I went to check it out. I looked to see the recording. I didn't press record. I am the biggest idiot in the world, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. So I have to tell you what happened. It was a great show. It was a wonderful show. It was a terrific show. We started off with me telling everybody to switch off their mobile phones and switch off their landline phones, pull the plug out of the wall, plug the wire out of the wall for Alexa. And every time I said Alexa, my Alexa in the other room would go off. Oh, I've got a little bit of a cough. I've had a cough for about 11 days. Can't get rid of it, but I will. So there we are. I introduced John Hutchinson, who is the co-host today. Lovely man, John. Love his style. He does a lot of radio work and that sort of thing, so he should know what he's doing. He sent me the photographs to get ready. He's told me what songs he wants, and there we are. It's going to be terrific. I asked John to tell what we were going to do on the show. He's going to introduce, how was your month, Dec? April for Dec, that's good. And then the Fields of Athenry, his favourite song. The old video diaries, and this time from June 2018, edit 1. That means next time it'll be edit 2. Then his best year, 1986, John Hutchinson. Why was it his best year? Why did he enjoy it as his best year? Then Danny Boy, which he loves. The birthdays, great. And then One Voice. And he told us a great story about One Voice, why he likes it, which I'll tell you later. And then his main bit, which was My Name is John Hutchinson, all the pictures, and he's going to do that in 5 to 7 minutes and explain. That's very Toastmasters, everything is timed. And then goodbye from me with I Wish You Love, which I've been working on for the last 5 weeks, and I absolutely adore it and love it to bits. So we got going. So how was my month? I got Lynn, really, first of all, to say how she enjoyed the show that I did in Eastbourne last week. And she did a lovely job of telling about that, how she loved the atmosphere. And that she was right at the front, and she was with my family. She was with Louisa, and she was with, she was right by Victoria, and right by Sandy and everybody else. So she had a lovely time and thanked me very much for the family. Looking after her. And then we got on to my month. What was my month last month? Have a look at this. Well, this is Easter. Easter 2023. And first time ever. It's like your first time ever not having Christmas at home. This is the first time I've ever not had Easter at home. I'm down with my son. Look at this. Now, is that enough Easter eggs? I'll tell you what, everybody brought flowers.
Flowers, there's flowers everywhere.
We're all just going to sit down now. Nice leg of lamb. It's going to be beautiful. Now, a good vet will get that back up and running. Honestly. Look at that. Meat. And the most vegetarians here. Let me have a look at that, right? Oh, that looks good. And there's a chicken over there as well.
Okay, so, carrots.
Now, this is going to be the grand rolling of the eggs. Now, Patch, I think you should move because you're right in the way. Patch, look at me when I'm talking to you. Look at me when I'm talking to you, Patch. Patch, look at me when I'm talking to you. There we are.
He's worried about the wheels.
We're going in. Okay. In order of age, oldest. Yeah, I'm 47.
Oh, what are you? The technique to do it. Put it in the fridge an hour before.
Really?
That's cheating.
That's now, okay.
Dad, can you record?
Oh no.
Grand rolling of the eggs. Here we go. Ready? What is it?
Oh,
oh, didn't go anywhere. Wait, no. Wait up.
In history to roll uphill.
Wait up. Yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Not bad.
Oh, that's
the only one. Right.
Even though you're younger than me, you
Lex,
you
just go age before being.
Surely you don't have
humanity. Oh, as well, come on. That was cheating. That was a throw. That wasn't a roll. You got very soft carpet, Oliver. That's the issue here.
Roll it down, not new carpet.
Remember which one's which.
You just be quiet.
Yeah.
We're having fun here.
Oh, that's a slow one. That didn't go very far.
I think the carpet is too soft.
The carpet is far too soft. No, they won't break.
At our kitchen.
They won't break. No. No. Here we are.
The problem is that these are too small.
Right, right.
There you go, Layla's got the idea.
Next year, we've got to have one big. Oh, ooh. No.
Top mine up.
No,
all good.
No, I think it's... Oh!
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 That was very nice.
Oh!
I just got one in the
shed. No, they won't break. Oh, none of them will break. None of them will break.
Oh, go next.
On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends.
And here we are, off we go, Victoria's car. And she's a pretty good driver. She drives too close to cars in front. That's the only complaint I have. And she gives me a hard time because I'm an advanced driver. But here she is, look, there we go. We're all set on the road again.
On the road again. I just can't wait to get on.
Oh, I just have to have a Magnum. When I'm in the car going to a gig, I just have to have a Magnum. I have to have a Magnum. So I'm going to get one now. And here we are. The dreaded holiday park. God, the springs are all back to me. All back to me. Trying to figure out how to get in, Victoria, yeah?
Well, no, I've got to go and find...
Find out how to get in.
Well, yeah. Where I'm going and what's the score. Whether I'm bringing my own
6-0
equipment or it's all in there. I need to find out.
Yeah, okay. On you go.
I will.
And this is the sort of situation I hate where you've got to bring all the stuff in the front door, all through all the people. Why do architects never think of having an entrance right beside the stage? So you just load the stuff straight in onto the stage. They do that in Australia, actually, in South Africa, places like that. But this country is very, very bad for that. Very bad. So the last thing they think of is the artist. And that's sound check done. And nice venue, lovely venue. In fact, the sound system is just absolutely brand new. So I think it's the first time it's been used for a show. And it sounds pretty good to me.
Maybe you can let out the dog, like the solar state. You will know it, come on, you're not that smart. Maybe you can let out the flower, on a harvest day. It's love, it never is. Hey, oh me, that's what it is.
I hope you enjoyed that. It always seems that we're eating in these videos. Every video I show you, we seem to be eating. It's not that. The family, like me, I love good food. I'm not a big eater, but I love the taste of good food. I don't like quantity. I just like the taste. And then we got on to Fields of Athenry. Why did John like it? He said every time, and he told of instances where he'd been up close and personal to us in the front row and looking at Con
and the way he worked all the words and meant every word he sang. And I said, this is, yeah, exactly. And when I was recording with him, he was exactly the same. We got onto the Fields of Athenry.
And this one is on the album. I think it's the most beautiful Irish song ever.
It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. Violent prison wall, I heard a young girl calling, Michael. So the young might see the morn. Now the prison ship lies waiting in the bay. It's so lonely round the fields.
Tales of Athenry, and that actually was done for a documentary that two guys were trying to flog, and they followed us around all over the place and filmed us in various venues. It was very good. I'm amazed it didn't get off the ground. I personally thought that they filmed too much of us singing in venues, and they should have had more of the personal touch of Colin and I chatting and people interviewing us, possibly. I thought that's where they possibly went wrong. Then we get on to the diaries. Everybody loves the video diaries. And this is from June 2018. Edit one, as I said before. Means there's going to be an edit two. Have a look at what we got up to pre-COVID times.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss.
Can you believe it? My daughter Victoria went to see the Stones in concert at one of the big stadiums in London. London Stadium. Now, I am so miffed. Look, she's raving about them. She doesn't realize. I'm miffed.
So the food is ready. Food is ready. Look at that. My goodness me. Prawns. Don't know what that is. Oh, it's cheese. Cheese. Bloomy. Bloomy.
Halloumi.
Halloumi. And they're lovely. And I don't like peppers.
You don't have to have them.
Peppers are not for me. Oh, look at that. That's gorgeous. I'm going to film my face.
Start me up.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Layla. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, that's two breaths.
Hip hip hooray.
Hip hip hooray.
Hip hip hooray.
Hip hip
hooray.
And a whisper of hooray.
Hooray. Should we get
another birthday?
What is it? Oh, the unicorn.
Aha.
No, turn it around so Granddad can take it.
No, would you like me to sing the unicorn?
No.
No.
Thank you very much.
No,
please.
Yeah.
Scream.
Well,
don't want to cut it. Why do I cut it? It's beautiful.
Right in the middle of his face.
No.
Here.
Right, chop it.
Wherever you like. You chop it wherever you like.
Here,
out the way. Three, two, one, go. When you reach the bottom, scream.
And off we go. For a sports massage. This should be good. I've never had a sports massage before. Now, this should be really interesting. Now, do you think I'm dressed okay? Dressed okay for a sports massage? Here we go. Oh, I love a bit of fun. I love a bit of fun. My chariot awaits. There's the bed. I wonder what's going to happen next. Gotta strip down to my undies. Ooh. I'll let you know what happens later. Well, I'm finished now.
Hold up.
Do I look any different?
I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
And I feel great. That's the good news.
And that's the latest. Up out into Victoria's garden. It's a nice fuchsia with some French marigolds down below. French marigolds. And I put French marigolds in there as well, which are not very nice. French marigolds seem to go really well in this garden. And together with some Asiatic lilies, make a nice display. Down there as well. And down there. Roses. Roses are doing really well this year, as everybody knows, I think. But I found out that I've really done this rockery a little bit wrong. I've put in a lot of grasses and the grasses simply don't like it. Somebody on the website has said, oh, well, you need to put grasses in on a rockery. Don't do it. And quite right.
Look at that one, as dry as a bone. No, I think grasses have got to be wet. And rockeries help.
The nature of rockeries is that they're quite dry. Mulleons are doing very well. And they were given to me by the gardener at Stanton Prior. Osteospermum doing really well. Pansies and that are not doing too well this year. Very strange. They normally do well here, but I think it's the dry weather. Geraniums, wild geraniums are fair favourite in gardens, doing really well. So there we have it, the garden is doing really well. Courtesy of Mr. Tusky.
Deep blow.
Thank
you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you so much. Can I just say thank you to all the chefs in the kitchen.
Whoa.
Hope you like that.
And all you guys, thank
Who
you
else
so
is
much.
Who knows John? His best year.
Hey!
Yes.
Oh, they.
John's best year. His best year. And I just get up the video here, and here we are. This is it. This is John's best year, and he explained to us about how many times he tried to get his BA degree and he just missed out on it, and he didn't have the time and everything else. And then he suddenly in 1986 decided, this is the time, John, you're going to do it. And he did it. And he's telling us that he is so proud of this moment and that photograph, and that would make his life. And I'm sure it certainly did. I asked John then about Danny Boy, and he again recounted times when he sat in the front row and felt that Con, among all the people who've tried it, all the Irish people particularly who've tried to sing it, and that Con got the most out of it. Con loved it. And Con always said to me, oh, I hate singing that song. If ever we were asked at a party to sing it, he'd say, oh God, I hate this song. And I never really knew whether he meant that or not. But I think, I agree with John here, he really got the most out of Danny Boy in this clip.
Danny Boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the flowers are dying. 'Tis you, 'tis you must go, and I must buy. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. 'Tis I'll be in sunshine or in shadow. Danny Boy, oh Danny Boy, I love you so. when ye come, and all the flowers are dying. If I am dead, as dead I well may be, ye'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say, an Ave there for me. And I shall hear the soft you tread above me, and all my grave will warmer, sweeter be. For you will until you come to me.
Then we got on to the birthdays, and I had a big apology to make because it's Victoria's birthday, my daughter, and the whole family are up at Kilkmere, which is right near me. You should go there. And actually, I've been up there and back since, and it's an amazing. They've taken what was an old ramshackle place there, the Kilkmere Inn, and one of the big people, I think it's Vintage Inns, have bought it, and they've spent millions on it. And it is quite stunning. A lot of place outside, which is lovely, by the Kilkmere River, and inside, and the food was stunning. I had a honey baked camembert with bread and chutney, and that was really delicious. I loved that. So we've now got a favorite place that we'll be going to quite often with the family. So the reason I was telling you about that was that my assistant, well, Sandy, really, she couldn't get the cake ready. And I couldn't do my trick of blowing the cake out. So I had to sing, and I've got it written down here, happy birthday to Kathy, John and Victoria. Happy birthday to Kathy, John and Victoria. Happy birthday to Kathy, John and Victoria. Happy birthday to Kathy, John and Victoria, and many more. And that's John Leyland, by the way, and Kathy Brown, and Victoria, my daughter. Looking at those videos, you know, the video diaries, it's amazing when you think Layla was 11 there. Good Lord, she's 16 now, and she is 5'10". That's my granddaughter. And she's already decided what she's going to do at college, university. She's going to do photography and film and all that. She's gone into that side of the business. She's always been very fond of getting my cameras out and everything, getting me to do all sorts of TV shows and everything. And she was working the cameras. Always been fond of that. And now she's going to do it for real. And the garden as well. I was talking about the garden. And I love doing the garden for Victoria, which is terrible. And the reason why the garden looked so forlorn, I suppose, and unlooked after, the fact that she doesn't water it. She just simply will not water the garden. Victoria, what are you doing? We then got on to John's next favourite, and he was talking about it was lovely that he was very fond of Barry Manilow in the day, and he always thought, oh, it'd be great if Bachelors would sing some Barry Manilow songs. And we did. We did Even Now and a few songs like that, which Con loved singing because he loved all the big songs, the big songs. And when I did it on Sunday, Sound of Sundays, he was absolutely astonished. And he felt as if it was our song. It wasn't Barry Manilow's song. And really, and then I told him the hidden secret in this was that Carol, Con's daughter, actually bet me and said, Uncle Dec, she calls me UD actually, UD, I bet you couldn't sing this song. And I could, but Con was always a bit funny about songs. He either loved the song or he didn't like it. And he wasn't, I don't think he was fond of the challenge. But as soon as we started recording it and Philip, his son, got involved, then obviously the father-son enmity thing came in and he just wanted to prove that he was the better singer than Philip. And let's listen to this video and looking at the video, it's quite obvious Con is the great singer. Con is the great singer. So let's get on and have a look. And he particularly liked what I did with it video-wise. I don't know where I get the ideas from. I say to John Leyland all the time, I haven't the faintest idea where the ideas come from, but I'm never short of ideas. They just seem to come to me. It's probably Con looking down, just hits me with them. But this is the beautiful video of One Voice.
Are we ready? One, two, three.
Just one voice singing in the darkness. All it takes is one voice singing, so they hear what's on your mind. And when you look around, you'll find there's more than one voice. Joining with your one voice, each and every note another octave, hands are joined and fears unlocked. If only one voice would start it on its own, we need just one voice facing the unknown, and then that one voice would never be alone. It takes that one
that one voice, just one
Wasn't that good? And of course, I got everybody to applaud, and everybody did applaud. And I looked up at Con. He's always up there. He's always up there. He's always with me, actually, Con. I don't feel as if he's gone at all. It's a very strange thing to say, but that's the way it is. I suppose grief hits people in different ways. But he's always up there, and he's always looking after me. He certainly looks after his little brother. He certainly does. Then we got on to, what's the next thing we got on to? I'm cheating here. I actually have it all written down. I'll tell you. My name is John Hutchinson. I said to him 5 to 7 minutes. It went much longer than that. I think it went to about 12 or 14 minutes. But it was lovely. And let me show you what he showed us. First of all, this one. This is at the North Beach in Scarborough, and he told stories about he loved, this family loved Scarborough. He used to go there twice a year. The North Side was his favourite, not the South Side. And of course he told us about going to the Futures Theatre, where we appeared. He saw us there. He saw us there twice, actually. And then he told us about seeing us at the Floral Hall. And I remind him that he didn't know the comic that was with us. Neil Reed was with us. He reminded me, and I'll tell you about Neil Reed in a minute. But we had Frank Carson as the comic with us. Neil Reed. We used to call him Real Need. He did a tour of South Africa with us, which was very, very interesting. His father was there. It was good. That was good fun. But recently I've been contacted by BBC and who else is involved? Lottery people. They got all this money together and they're doing a film on Lena Zavaroni. An actual proper film, cinema film on Lena Zavaroni. And they've asked me to get involved. And of course they want Real Need involved as well, because he was with the same office, Dorothy Solomon's office. And of course I ring up Dorothy, I must ring her in a minute actually. I ring her all the time, and I go down to Bournemouth and take her out to lunch at least every month. And I'll be doing that probably next week. During the week I go now, because Sundays have got a little bit impossible. So there we are, we're doing that film, and that's Neil Reed and Dorothy. So that's 1961, and that's the John Hutchinson we know as a little tiny little boy. He showed us a picture of his mother and explained to us this was in there, quite a huge garden. Must have been lovely. That looks like a good garden. It's not in the best season of the year to see the garden, but that's his mother. Lovely lady. And then his father, we talked about his father a lot and asked us, did we think that he looked a bit like his father? Yes, he does. I think you do, John. I think you do. And he explained to us that was in the dining room. He said it all always looked strange, that photograph, because it looked like it was in the library or something like that. And being over Dad as being a big posh man in the library. Come and see me in the library, my boy. And then I got on to the next lot. John explained that in his work, they decided they'd have pantomimes each year, and he was one of the ones that got involved. Top left, he thought he was like Shrek. But he wasn't. He wasn't like Shrek at all. He was like somebody with horns out of his head. I don't know why. And green makeup. We didn't quite remember what that was all about. And the next one with the duck. Again, no memory for that at all. And then the next one was when they were doing something about Downton Abbey. And he was playing a sort of an Inspector Clouseau type of character in Downton Abbey. Don't know what Inspector Clouseau was doing in Downton Abbey, but that's what they did. He said... They used to do that when he was on day release. I couldn't understand what he was meaning about day release from prison. Maybe he was in prison. Well, let's get on now. That was the next one. Let's see now. Oh, yeah, this is a funny one, this. He got involved with, do you remember when calendar girls were all the thing? Oh, quite a few years ago now. It must be about 15 years ago, 20 years ago. And everybody was doing the calendar girls. And then they got onto the idea of calendar boys. Con and I actually did one as well, for calendar boys, and that was him. And he told us that they sold out and sold out and sold out. Every print they did of the calendar was sold out. And they made quite a few thousand pounds, which is very nice. And then he sent me this picture. And I said to him, John, what was that picture all about? Because you didn't explain it very well. Well, he didn't give me any explanation. And he couldn't figure out himself what the picture was. So we're left wondering what the heck the picture was at all, at all, at all, at all. So that was John with his 5 to 7 minutes, which turned out to be 12 or 14 minutes. But very, very enjoyable. And then I said we were getting on to the end of the show and the replay would be available. It'll be a pretty quick replay because I forgot to record the blooming thing. And here I am doing it. I hope you enjoyed this pressy of what we got up to. And I hope you join us again on the 4th of June, which is in 3 weeks' time. So I'll have to be pretty quick. In fact, I asked people, I had an idea, because we've never recorded a video of Somewhere, one of our favourite songs, one of the biggest songs we've ever done on stage. So I said, what would people think if I did it? And everybody seemed to say, yeah. So there you have it. That's what I'm going to be doing in the next 3 weeks. I'll do my version. I've already got ideas floating around in my mind, and we do Somewhere. But then we got on to I Wish You Love. And this was a strange one, I Wish You Love. John Leyland asked me to record it. He dared me to record it, I think. I had a number one hit with it. Well, I say I had a number one. The Bachelors had a number one hit with it in Mexico during the heyday, you know, in the 60s. And we knew nothing about it, little about it at all. Didn't float back to us at all that we had a number one. And it was me singing the lead. And it's been in the back of my mind all through the years. And John Leyland said, have a listen to it and see what you can do with it. So I took it and started from the bottom upwards. Wrote everything as I always do. Wrote the whole thing, the orchestration. I loved doing it. The strings, I wrote, and greater boasting, you know. I think the strings are probably the best strings I've ever written. And the guitar playing is lovely. I'm very, very fond of my guitar playing. I do feel I do a blooming good job on it. But see what you think of this one. I think it's over the top. John Leyland doesn't think so. And I always send stuff to John first to see, is it okay? And he says it's okay. So here is I Wish You Love.
Goodbye, but before you walk away, I sincerely want to say, I wish you bluebirds in the spring. To give your heart the song to sing, and then a kiss. But more than this, I wish you love. And in July, your lemonade to cool you in some leafy glade. I wish you health and more than wealth. I wish you love, my breaking heart.
my very best. I set you free. I wish you shelter from the storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm. But most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you love. And let a kiss, but more than this, I wish you love. I wish you health, and more than wealth, I wish you love. My breaking heart, and I agree that you and I could never be. So with my best, my very best, I set you free. I wish you shelter from the storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm. But most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you love. I wish you love. I wish you love.
I made Con very jealous, didn't I, Con? I made him very, very jealous that I was getting all the plaudits on my own. I didn't need him. Ah, I do. I do need you, Con. I miss you. I suppose I say I don't miss you, but I think I do. So there we are. This is the wrap-up. And I said to people, stick around and chat for a while. And if you've gotten any email requests for me to try and have a bash at, send me an email, dec@makeit.com. I'll put it on the screen, dec@makeit.com. Next show is on June the 4th. Don't forget, and that'll be a good one in 3 weeks' time. The mics will be open, as I said, and here we are. And this is me saying goodbye until the next time. Bye.
My breaking heart, and I agree that you and I could never be. So with my best